Throughout the years, we've seen a great deal of good versus evil stories and ancient rivalries, perhaps none more iconic than that which stems from the character of Dio Brando in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, written by Hirohiko Araki. The story of Dio versus the Joestar name is an incredibly captivating story element, but what exactly makes it so interesting? What exactly was Araki's philosophy in writing such a well-received rivalry? Luckily, the mangaka himself has discussed in interviews and in the actual manga volumes themselves, just what was going on in that mind of his when it came to creating his story. Dio was the very first villain of the series to the very first Joestar, Jonathan, starting in part 1, Phantom Blood, which, by the way, I will say to all those looking to get into JoJo's, if you've ever heard someone say that it's okay to skip part 1, ignore that, that's not true. But anyways, when it came to beginning the series, this is what Araki was thinking about. The character he was most interested in drawing actually wasn't JoJo, it was Dio. Other characters would, of course, later cross the lines of black and white, but to introduce the series, Araki wanted a very clear line of good and evil. When writing the first Joestar, he wrote him specifically to be a symbol of dignity, hope, justice, and purity against the stark contrast of the corrupt, maniacal symbol of evil that is Dio. Araki as well has, let's just say, he has a very obvious flair for the rule of cool, which is the reason why he chose Dio, the Italian word for God, to challenge the name of JoJo. It's a classic good guy, bad guy story that just feels somewhat comforting to watch. The closest thing that I can compare it to would probably have to be maybe watching the old Superman movies as a kid. That sense of justice versus the bad guy, you know? JoJo's obviously goes a little farther in certain areas than Superman, but the principle of the rivalry still stands. Jonathan was written as a passive character alongside Dio, as in he reacts to Dio's actions. And Araki has said that reacting to what he wrote for Dio helped develop and grow the characters, specifically of JoJo and the Joestars, along the way. Creating a weakness for such a character as Dio also, Araki has said, proved difficult, as the hope-ending invincible appearance was part of what made Dio so intimidating as a villain, but how do you counter that? Starting out with the actual, you know, character of Dio. He comes from an unfortunate family situation, as you may know, and vows to take over the Joestar name, in debt to and also in spite of his deceased abused father. Bit of a spoiler alert, kind of. I mean, but if you know anything about JoJo's, you probably know that, yes, Dio is not done after part 1. He comes back, surprise, wow, crazy. And this time with the new and now most popular power in JoJo's, the Stand. Dio's direct intentions escalate with each appearance, of course, but his characterization comes from real FBI profiling of serial killers, the way that some serial killers use psychological manipulation to gain a sense of control over their victims was directly applied to Dio's character. He now gains his own power over his followers with his own charisma. Araki has come forward on all the media that has influenced the series as well, and when it comes to writing his villains, not all of these I guess have directly influenced Dio himself specifically, because I mean some of these projects were released after he wrote Dio, but Araki is still writing JoJo's and his ideology on writing his villains continues to grow. Here are just a few things that have influenced Araki's take on villains to get a kind of sense of how he approaches writing these things. Films like Silence of the Lambs centers on a serial killer that creates a terrifying atmosphere from the uncertainty of existence. We can't tell when he will kill or why he kills exactly. Everything feels random and it creates a frightening and uncomfortable experience. Frost Nixon from 2008 portrays a former US president as someone trying to exonerate themselves by manipulating people with their own mind games. Hereditary shows the fear of the supernatural, haunting whoever speaks about it. Joker explains evil as being a product of today's society, and Sherlock Holmes from Sir Arthur Conan Doyle not only influenced Araki's villains, but also the fundamentals of storytelling that Araki abides by, which upon reading that really makes a lot of sense as to why the story structure and characters of JoJo's are so charismatic and engaging. Anyway, back to Dio versus Joestar. In order to create such an iconic rivalry, Dio needed to be truly hateable. Hateable in a likable way, if you know what I'm saying. A delightful evil, let's call it. But right off the bat, Araki uses the most effective tool in showing how bad a bad guy is, and succeeds in making us immediately hate him, all from a little technique called, prepare yourself, animal abuse. Yes, we hate animal abuse. It's bad. I don't think I need to say that. But here's the thing in the story, right? In lots of different media, they do this. Show us a cute animal, have a character abuse that animal, job done. We hate that character now. And in JoJo's, especially since that animal, Danny, the dog, had such a strong connection with our noble character, Jonathan. Right off the bat, we've already begun to develop this iconic versus story. From the beginning of Dio aiming for power over the Joestar name, shaping him into the most prolific villain of the entire series, Dio's character is all about the pursuit of power. His unmoving ambition against the purity of Jonathan and the lone hero of Jotaro is what shapes not only these characters, but the world of JoJo's as well. When it came to writing Dio's ambition, Araki developed the character to take on a might makes right philosophy, let's say, meaning the stronger you are, the more power you deserve and can take. Hence, absolute power leads to absolute control, and that is the evil of Dio Brando. In fact, Dio literally abandons his own humanity as a means of attaining this control that plagues his mind. Araki broke down his philosophy for writing such an iconic villain as well, which plays into why the public took such an interest in this character. Araki said that the actual root of evil lies within horror itself. The reason Dio is so imposing comes from his grudge on the Joestar name. Since he is an immortal vampire, he takes on an almost horror villain persona, where even if he's seemingly defeated in the moment, he will always come back to haunt the Joestars in one way or another. Rather than creating a villain where the power of invincibility and violence is the main drive in that moment itself, Dio becomes a symbolic curse to a family, one that focuses more on the transcendence of time over momentary defeat. Dio's grudge is so frightening because his anger spans generations of the Joestar family. His rage is continuously fueled to the point where nothing will stop him from destroying this family. Araki has also stated the reason for evil being written like this and why it becomes so compelling for the reader. Dio, all the memes aside obviously, comes from, as previously stated, the idea behind real life serial killers. This evil, when unknowable, becomes a game of fascination and fear to the public. That kind of sounds bad when you say it, but it's true. Why do you think Netflix keeps putting out so many serial killer documentaries? Because people watch them. The idea of trying to wrap your head around and discover what makes this evil tick is why people are so compelled by these stories. How do you look into the philosophy behind a villain who seems to want nothing but to watch the world burn? Their actions feel impossible to predict, and that's why our brains focus so intently on the story. I mean, when you look at it, so many adventure stories focus on mystery and the elements that appear maybe initially out of our comprehension. We try to understand what we don't know, and we're pulled into the story this way. This is why he writes his antagonistic forces in his stories as such a mystery. It drives the viewer crazy for the story. Paired with the stark contrast of the Joestars, Dio has grown into one of the most iconic villains in the world of manga and, I mean, anime as well. And that's all the thanks to the brilliance and intentionality of one Hirohiko Araki. Thanks for tuning in. I've been Shin Glassman, along with a call to subscribe, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.